First of all, I welcome you all to this press conference. As you are aware, that the term of legislative assemblies of Goa, Manipur, Punjab, Uttarakhand, and Uttar Pradesh are due to expire in this year on March 15th, March 19th, March 23rd, and again March 23rd and May 14th, respectively. A total of 690 assembly constituencies will go poll this time.
हमारे समक्ष यहाँ पर भारत निर्वाचन आयोग के मुख्य चुनाव आयुक्त श्री सुशील चंद्रा जी हैं, चुनाव आयुक्त श्री राजीव कुमार जी और चुनाव आयुक्त श्री अनूप चंद्र पांडे जी यहाँ मौजूद हैं। आयोग के वरिष्ठ अधिकारी भी यहाँ पर हैं। मैं अब मुख्य चुनाव आयुक्त श्री सुशील चंद्रा जी से अनुरोध करूंगी, कृपया आप सबको संबोधित करें।
ऑनरेबल श्री राजीव कुमार जी, इलेक्शन कमिश्नर, श्री अनूप चंद्र पांडे जी, इलेक्शन कमिश्नर, सीनियर कुलीग्स फ्रॉम ECI एंड ऑल मीडिया फ्रेंड्स, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस। एज यू आर अवेयर that the term of legislative assemblies of Goa, Manipur, Punjab, Uttarakhand and Uttar Pradesh are due to expire in this year on March 15th, March 19th, March 23rd and again March 23rd and May 14th respectively. A total of 690 assembly constituencies will go poll this time. These includes 40 assembly constituencies in Goa, 60 assembly constituencies in Manipur, 117 ACs in Punjab, 17 ACs in Uttarakhand, and 403 ACs in Uttar Pradesh. The Constitution of India places upon ECI the solemn responsibility to conduct timely elections. It is the right of citizens to exercise their sovereign will and elect their representatives. For the past 2 years, the impact of COVID-19 has made conduct of elections extremely challenging. All those present here today and those listening to us have been part of this journey, full of trials and tribulations. It is our duty to see how to conduct elections in a manner that protects both the voters and the vote. As the country faces a surge of COVID cases and emergence of a new variant, Commission would like to explain in some detail the new protocols that have been put in place for conducting forthcoming elections in a free, fair, participative, accessible and safe manner. But before that, we would like to explain, we would like to tell you something about the various preparations which we have done. We work with three broad objectives this time, and foremost is the COVID safe election. Second is hassle free, comfortable voting experience to the voters, and third, the maximum voter participation. Friends, for last 6 months, the entire election machinery was gearing up for these elections. Periodic reviews were done and senior officers of ECI held detailed meetings to review all aspects of poll preparations. A lot of advanced planning and meticulous preparation has been done. In the month of December 2021, Commission visited the poll bound states to review poll preparedness, and we also had a virtual meeting with the political parties of Manipur and their officers. We discussed with various political parties and elicited their views and suggestions. We also met the chief secretaries, DGPs, DOs, SPs, and various enforcement agencies in the states on various issues of preparedness. As the COVID cases showed a resurgence, especially in view of the new variant of concern, that is Omicron, Commission held meetings with Health Secretary, Government of India, and health experts as well, health secretaries of the states. We also had discussions with the Union Home Secretary on this issue. After taking all these views and the opinions and the ground situation, we decided to announce elections to the 5 states with safety norms in place. At the heart of election process lies the sanctity and absolute veracity of the electoral roll.